Hey guys, hope you are doing well. Hope you started the new year, the new week, first day of the new week with full passion and enthusiasm. And we are heading into a fantastic week with fantastic crypto gains and happenings out there. So my name is Mike Denkler from CoreIONX, and I'm bringing you the most important crypto news, technical analysis, altcoin, DeFi, NFT, gems every day to keep you updated and educated. I should state that nothing in this video can be considered as a financial or investment advice, so everything just for your education and for entertainment purposes only. So always do your own research and buy and hold or trade crypto accordingly, and don't invest more than you would able to afford to lose. So let's share my screen and let's jump into our favorite bubble chat. But before that, please smash those like, push the bell notification, or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. And let's go and let's check what the bubble chart is showing to us. So we see a few altcoins are correcting, especially SafeMoon, and few coins that pumped really well in the past few weeks and days, like Avalanche, Galo, and Celo. But few others are pumping, like Near Protocol again, Algorand, Phantom, Atom, Link, Tezos, Hex, Aave, Rose, Uniswap, and Curve as well, and One Harmony. So we see these are almost all the layer one solutions. So Near, Argo, Phantom, One, Luna, Atom, Tezos, all are layer one solutions, and maybe Clay too. So this is how the smart contract protocol are emerging. But we see Bitcoin is down 1%. Now it's traded about 4,600, and Ethereum is down as well, almost 1%, and traded about 3,700. So that looks not too good, but even few altcoins are doing less. So I think Bitcoin is losing some dominance yet again. So let's check our favorite indicator, the crypto fear and greed index. Let me refresh this, because 29, but the market is more bearish now. So we see that fear is back, and also especially we dipped to 2022, 2021 zone in the past few days, and also the index was at the lower level at sorry for that, somebody calling me. Okay, I hope you cannot hear this. Sorry for that, guys. I just writing to a guy that not call me, so I hate when somebody calling me on Telegram. Sorry for that, just a moment. Okay. So let's go. So we saw the index going down at the levels of 16, 18, 20, and this is an extreme fear. And we know when investors are so fearful, then it's always a good buying opportunity. But when investors are getting ready, it's due for a correction. It's better to take some profits. Also, there's a saying from Warren Buffett that be fearful when others are greedy, and be greedy when others are fearful. So just remind this one, there is a FUD going around and the price is going down and the fear is going higher and higher, then this is something that maybe now the time is better to look for buying opportunities, better than at new all-time highs. So Bitcoin network turns 13, celebrates with new hash rate all-time high. So Bitcoin is 13 euros old as a teenager, and the hash rate new all-time high, and price used to follow hash rate. This is just an addition to this. Okay, Bitcoin hash rate fell to these lows in July because the China Bitcoin mining ban. And then the hash rate came back, and now it is about 200 exahashes. So that's huge, 207 exahash per second. Okay, what Filippo is saying, MicroStrategy's Bitcoin for Corporations conference in February 2021, public companies holding significant BTC have gained market share from spot ETFs as a way to access BTC exposure on public equity markets. MicroStrategy and public mining companies, mainly Grayscale. So, corporate treasuries, spot ETFs, and Grayscale holding more and more Bitcoin. I will show you this also on Twitter, and you will be able to share this. So this is a good news. So hash rate is up, and price used to follow hash rate. So Bitcoin dips below $47,000 as US dollar surge dampens BTC price performance. Okay, so US dollar surge, that is why Bitcoin is dumping now. Q1 is up only, you heard it here first. So this is a Twitter account from Galaxy summarized. It's just a matter of time before BTC breaks out, and the longer it takes, the harder it will pump. So about Ethereum, good buys from Ethereum, and I think this one is bottomed. Still need additional confirmation, but shows more strength than Bitcoin at this point. Ultimate confirmation about 4,100. So Ethereum should go about 4,500 to become bullish again. But as we see, maybe Ethereum is also dumping further for now, but we'll see. Yes, the US dollar meanwhile saw a sudden boost on January 3, with the US dollar currency index rapidly gaining, as is customary to Bitcoin's detriment. So the US DIX index pumped. Never mind the bearish divergence. TechDev is posting here. The two points are valid to point out, but I don't focus on them as they have not been historically accurate at identifying macro cycle trends changes. Two that have macro LSC and two weak RSI floor breaks, neither of which have happened. Halving cycles, tops, bottoms, and RSI. And now RSI is not done yet. We know we now have billionaires, multinationals, and countries waiting to buy the dips. Whoever is taking the other side of the trade needs their head examined, in my opinion. This is from Alistair Mion. Good to see that. So, guys, let's go to our next news. Bitcoin holdings of public companies surges in 2021. Yes, Willy Wu posted this. We already have seen this. Yeah. In 2020, the amount of BTC held by public companies surged 400% in 4 months to 3.6 billion, as reported by Cointelegraph. And I think they wanted to write 2021. But I think just MicroStrategy holding more than 3.6 billion. So that is not correct. So yeah, let's check this. ETFs corporations together totaled almost 1 million BTC according to the chart. So you see this huge spike, huge increase that institutionals are stacking. Okay, let's go and check this news. We have another news here I wanted to show you. Top five cryptocurrencies to watch this week: BTC, Luna, Phantom, Atom One. So Luna, Phantom, Atom One, all they are layer ones, and also they are still pumping. So Nayib Bukele thinks Bitcoin could rally to $100,000 this year. And BTC USDT, if we are pulling up this Fibonacci, then we see Bitcoin almost retested all the levels and now finding support and waving between support and resistance, but still in the downtrend. Luna USDT. So Luna looks really good, and this is the 20 moving average, 20 day moving average, and this is the 50 day moving average, and Luna bounced really nicely at the 20 day moving average. And on a short term time frame, yeah, Luna Fibonacci Luna retraced to the starting point, and this is where we have an uptrend line now. On short time, it looks really bullish. Phantom is doing a kind of we should have a price target above three, the previous all time high. So that let me look into Phantom. So this is a kind of cup and holder, I can say. MSDT also doing well and breaking the horizontal resistance line here. So one Harmony also formed a cup and holder, also the daily chart, and also there's a small cup and holder on the on the 4 hour chart. You see it's better, but this is what we see on the daily. So I think all these are good trades, but you should plan your trades. You should use, and you should learn more how to trade. What is the reward at the ratio that it should be at least at 1.2 to 1. So 2 for profits and 1 to the loss. You should use definitely stop loss. Okay, let's go and our next news. Top crypto analyst updates massive Bitcoin prediction for this year. Here is his target. Okay, who is this? TechDev is the guy. After more research, I have come to believe this next possible final impulse would come after 2 weeks close over the 1.618, as they always have. If this happens, it may provide a timeline estimate, but it honestly doesn't matter, and I don't plan to focus on it. Okay, so he is this Fibonacci extensions, and hearing the previous, he's starting from the previous all-time high, and 2.272 is the next all-time high, and doing the same, starting the Fibonacci extension here, and 2.272 is the next all-time high, and also we see some crossing. We crossed the regression line, we crossed the regressions, and also crossed 1.618. So this is it's crossing, and yeah, so somewhere in the future. But still, if this was in the past two all-time highs, then we can expect Bitcoin to 225,000 US dollars. Some believe the cycle already ended. Some believe it drops in Q4. Some later, some never. I believe in data-based probability with invalidation points, which to me suggests the top is not in, but it will be this year. So first halving, second halving, third halving, and the top 2.272 will be there. Will be the top. Cool, looks good. Let's go to our next news. Over almost 467 million dollars worth of Bitcoin leaves crypto exchange Coinbase in just 1 week, analytics firms CoinGlass reports. So what was on Coinbase? So let's check this. Bitcoin balances on exchanges. So Bitcoin balances on exchanges decreasing, increased a little bit, but overall in, decreasing. And it shows that less and less Bitcoin are available on the exchanges. Whereas currently, 24% of the total supply, we already talked in the yesterday video. And you see the holdings at 1st of January. and Nadi are holding 24% of the total circulating supply. So nearly 10,000 US-based crypto exchange Coinbase in the last 7 days. So guys, what do you think? Why investors are withdrawing from exchanges? Do you think they want to sell, or do you think they want to hold for a long term and putting on the ledger, not putting on the cold storage? That also you should put your coins on a ledger nano. You will find the ledger nano link to the ledger nano link in the description. So this is the best and the most secure way to store your crypto. You think they are withdrawing because they want to sell? No. If they wanted to sell, they wouldn't withdraw it, but they would store on the exchanges and setting up sell orders and distributing the tokens on the exchange, but they are not doing that. Okay, so that's good news for now. Let's go to our next news. Overall, 20,000 Bitcoin installed in a year. So I think this is right, but let's check this. Okay, the number of crypto ATMs grown exponentially in 2021 with over 20,000 new installations since last December. That's more than the total of all crypto tether machines put into operation in the previous 7 years. Now we have almost 34,000 crypto ATM available globally. So this is globally. So, and you see the number is increasing and it's going exponentially and people are loving it. If you are educated a little bit about crypto, then I don't recommend you to use these ETMs because they are really expensive. So you find a better way to order a crypto card or top up account with your credit card or debit card. And also you can order a nice Binance card or crypto.com card, and definitely you find the links and you find bonuses and some free bitcoins if you are using our links, our Core Ionex links. You find it in the description. I like both Binance card and crypto.com card, so I recommend to order those ones. So piece of news is we have several Ethereum related news. Ethereum reached new milestone as over 71 million wallets hold Ethereum. 71 million wallets. So we have approximately 150 or maybe 200 million crypto wallets, crypto holders, and out of it 71 million Ethereum. So in number of non-zero addresses, you see the Ethereum price. What was this? No. This is the Ethereum price, and this is the number of addresses. So it's going up and up and up, and it cannot be stopped. Even those layer ones coming and other competitors, smart contracts, protocols coming, still Ethereum gaining momentum. Ethereum gaining the netcost low, the network effect. So this is definitely huge. So what's causing the rise? Decentralized finances, NFTs. These are the two main important narratives within Ethereum. So decentralized finance, lendings, decentralized exchanges, farming, stakings. And this is why Core Ionex is also focusing on stakings, and we are available not just on centralized exchanges but also on decentralized exchanges, and also lending protocols like we have our partner InLock, and you will find the link in the description where you can look up your crypto at InLock and get out a stable coin loan, and you don't have to spend your crypto. Okay, so and NFTs. So NFTs, we will talk about NFTs a lot because we have something that we are working on. You will like it because it's it's an amazing thing in the NFT metaverse. So guys, let's go to our next news, and also this will be an Ethereum related news. Ethereum showing strength over Bitcoin. Will it outperform once again in 2022? We will see. 2020 ending the last year with a solid 250% return, so 2.5 times what Ethereum did. So that's huge. Ethereum managed to outperform its total BTC by a great margin. Ethereum is showing more strength than Bitcoin's point. Beautiful retest of the region around 3,500, which should be enough for this correction, clear confirmation break bar 4,100. So the 4,100 levels there, and then Bitcoin can get this trend reversal pattern and building up higher highs and higher lows, and then the trend would reverse here. Many analysts had given $10 price targets for Ethereum by the end of 2021. However, that didn't materialize, but this hasn't stopped analysts from being bullish about Ethereum going into 2022. Shark Tank's Kevin O'Leary bets big on. He says that the entire crypto industry augment teams. Plus, he continues to be more bullish on Ethereum than over Bitcoin. Ether is my largest position, bigger than Bitcoin. It's because so many of the financial services and transactions are occurring on it. Even new software is being developed by Polygon that consolidates transactions and reduces the overall cost in terms of gas fees on Ethereum. And it's going to proof of stake that hope will happen during the summer this year. Not in the next decade, but this year. Next piece of news is how Ethereum will be transformed in 2022. Here are five of the top changes to expect with Ethereum's impending additions to proof of stake. Lower energy consumption. So for proof of work, so they are using the traditional miners and electricity and the proof of work method. And they will, the block production will move to proof of stake and is able to run with significant lower energy consumption. So they will save almost 99.95% of the energy that they used. Deflationary return. So the AIP 1559, they are burning a part of the Ethereum gas fees. And also, they already burned a tremendous amount of Ethereum. Let me check this because we have this Ultrasound Money page. Definitely follow this site, Ultrasound Money. And let's see, all. Show me all. They burn 1.3 million Ethereum already. So they burn 0.3 million Ethereum already. So this is huge. And this is almost more than 40 billion US dollars. Just an amount of coin that they already burned. So, okay. So the deflationary, same execution layer, Ethereum's current execution layer will be ported over the incoming proof of stake consensus layer supported by the clients that are currently in charge of ETH1. For existing users and applications, this means that interacting with Ethereum will remain incredibly similar post-merge, so they don't have to migrate or doing some migration, so they will just use and continue to use. Increase similar transaction fees. So the block size will increase, and the transaction time will increase, the transaction fees will decrease, and also they'll use upgrades, sharding, rollups, core data, and improvements after the merge to focus on increased scalability without sacrificing decentralization. And a road to decentralization and scalability and running on a validator on the Beacon chain requires 32 Ethereum, an upfront investment of over $120 at current prices. Why this is not a low barrier to enter? Remove economic offset that exists in mining over chains. Replacing hash power with randomness statistic and king box size, Ethereum enables and user with rich hardware to be run as Ethereum validator. So as Ethereum validator, I think you can earn almost 5 APR, if I'm right. So net participation rate was the total ETC supply deposited in this contract is almost 7%. Okay. Validate text backgrounds. Okay. Yeah, these are not so important. So we do have MX also based on Ethereum, initially built based on Ethereum. But as the gas prices went too high, that we so made a bridge that CoreMX can use on Binance Chain with much lower fees. So ZK rollups and ZK syncs set up a step into the timeline after the quest to scale Ethereum evolves. So ZK rollups became the latest trending solution for scalability on the Ethereum network as developers strive to increase throughput capabilities while decreasing transaction costs. And with these ZK rollups, also you should watch out and do ZK rollups because then you are you can earn some free coins. So ZK thing gaining transition ZK rollup narrative. So this is definitely huge. According to two fees for through zigzag on ZK syncs, the lowest fees. Okay, guys, let's just speed it because I have to go. NFT trading volume surpassed 13 billion in 20. So this is huge. And NFT trading volume increased. You see, this is the monthly started to increase in August. In August, so NFT started to pump August. Now just a little bit coming back, but I still expect NFTs will drive the market and also gaming will drive the market. Point is new gold. 4 million US Falcon Finance investor says, let's face the fact, I think Bitcoin hedge is in the minds of many of younger investors has replaced gold. The coins are the new gold for a million years. I think that's the story of gold, the fact that the young generation is regarding Bitcoin as the substitute. So this is definitely huge. And also we have another article that millionaires plan to make more cryptocurrency investments in 2022. So millionaires, so that's why they are millionaires, because they invested in crypto a few years back. At least 8 millionaires own cryptocurrency according to the surveys. This is you check out this news if you want to among these millionaires. I'm not a millionaire, but millennial. But that is going to be a millionaire as just you do. Samsung launches first smart TV with NFT and trading options. So Samsung also developed a Samsung phone with integrated crypto wallets, and now they are launching smart TV with the NFT aggregation platforms. This is definitely huge. Next piece of news is breaking. Binance acquire outstanding shares of crypto Visa card issuer Swipe. So if you order Binance card, it's provided by Swipe, but they wanna control Swipe and using for expanding their card business as well. Next piece of news is Israel Central Bank forces all banks to accept profits from cryptocurrency report. They declined clients to open a bank account because they wanted to deposit some funds earned in crypto. So Israel Central Bank enforced that they may no longer refuse to accept profits generated from cryptocurrency activities. this is how the industry is developing. Guys, check out Sandbox. It's good to use your Sand tokens because you can participate in a few drops like the Minto NFTs, and also now you can farm on Sandbox. But definitely check out our Twitter profile. We have this, I share this, so just follow me at MIKLWestDankler. Follow me and also follow Corey on X. And this is the happy birthday, the first Genesis block of Bitcoin. Follow Corey on X. We are sharing these videos and some updates, crypto updates every day. So at Corey on platform, and you see how Cardano ecosystem is increasing, how Atom wallets increase, and what RoPal has a nice thread. Just read this through, and a lot of other interesting news. These are the Ethereum 2.0 stake deposits that are just increasing further. And what else do we have here? Yes, the fear and greed is getting so high. So the sentiment is really so high. Then downside at 30 days. This is this interview on Spotbox from Wharton Jeremy Siegel, that digital coins are new gold for millennials. So guys, follow me at CoreyNX on Twitter, and also visit our farm. But before, I want to show you this. So check out the DAO token. If you spend more than almost 1,560 US dollar in gas fees on Ethereum network, then definitely you are for gas DAO, and claim your gas DAO token. But to show you, visit corion.app.corion.io, and you find our farms on Binance Smart Chain. You can earn up to 300% yield, providing liquidity on banking. And also, if you are holding ASC 20 version of CoreyNX, then you can farm on and provide liquidity to Uniswap. It's still live, so 330% API. So guys, it was great to have you here. Please like, put the bell notification on, subscribe to the channel, and see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Have a wonderful and just dive into this year. Bye-bye.